Just wait for the dogs and them to pass by, and then we're just going to drop down over here. As we all know, as I said many times before, dogs are the worst thing about any Souls game in history. And they... if I could choose to eradicate one enemy in the game, it would probably be dogs. It would probably be dogs. Speaking of dogs, over here we're about to find a shortcut. Actually, a pretty useful shortcut, I guess. It just means that we don't have to go back to the area we're already in. Oh, that was... You scared me. No. Don't do that. Holy crap, at least we got some gloves. Worker gloves. Never do that again. Let's see what this says. Try fire. Yeah, fire is good. But just the kind of straight approach works as well. Like, this weapon is OP, guys. It has always been OP. Mr. Epic Namebro, Marcus himself. I was gonna say Marcus Phoenix, but Marcus Epic Namebro actually believes this weapon is the best dex weapon in the entire game. And from a man who lives and swears by the dexterity of weapons. Like, he's a dex lord. I believe him. I definitely believe him. Okay, let's keep it going. Hello? Here we go. Don't be alarmed. For the people who played Dark Souls 1, holy crap, this is nothing. Because as we know, the giant rat in Dark Souls 1 is probably the most unique enemy in the game, just because there's one of them, and he's not a boss. We can go here later, but we won't need to go there later. We actually will not at all. It's a pretty useless locked door. I guess if you want to avoid some different things and avoid some enemies, it's not a useless locked door, but I just feel like it's a pretty useless locked door for me and my uses and everything I need to do. So here's a bonfire. We're going to rest here. Someone wants to be summoned. Too bad. Too bad. Not going to happen. Just keep it running. They give you a lot of leeway in this game, so don't worry about it. Honestly, don't worry too much about it, I should say. I actually need a better shield, so that's gonna happen next. I have to, like, raise up my strength to wear the kite shield. Because I do not like having less than 100% block on a shield. I know some people don't mind it because it's better for parrying. But I won't be doing much parrying. I'm more of a shady backdoor deal backstabber. Okay. These guys are fucking annoying. These guys are really annoying. We have to get down there. Our main goal today is to get down to there to get the Titanite shard. We have to get a few more Titanite shards before we can upgrade our weapon to +3. Thank God this guy's coming. You're making my life so much easier. Fuck. Okay, they're not coming back yet. They're not coming back yet. Okay, so this guy's making our lives a little bit easier by coming straight up to us. But not by attacking us. It seems like battery's low every time I frickin' open up. Okay, we're about two of these guys are here, so we're just gonna make a run for it up here, guys. I'm sorry. There's no way now. There are a few items up there. We'll come back for them. Don't worry. We'll come back. We'll come back. But up here is a bonfire, and I actually want to get it. Okay. Hello.
Another one of those unkindled, are you? All you faceless undead, behaving as if you deserve respect. No matter. Heed my words. If you've any sense, you'll go find a coffin to huddle up inside. You, here, in this land of hollows. You're like a frail maiden on the front lines. If, like the others, you're fool enough to play the champion, then go on ahead. Traipse right past the abandoned church. you'll face death. And it won't be pretty. Enough death to leave you broken. Time after time.
Yeah. Okay. Up here, we're gonna actually hit a bonfire and, oh, what's that smell? What is that ungodly smell? Guys, I smell onions. I smell onions. Oh, what is that smell? Oh. Do you guys smell the onion? Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's all in my head.
Oh. I am Siegvert of Katarina. To be honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle. Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow? Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower. Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them. But I have to find a way up, and that's just the trouble. This lift only goes down, you see, and... Well, that doesn't get me anywhere.
Yeah. That's Sigurd, I think his name was Sigurd, of Katarina. Now we're actually gonna meet, oh, I shouldn't have done that, I stepped on by accident, but we're actually gonna meet the guy who's been shooting those arrows at us in the last episode. Turns out he's not that bad of a guy.
Who are you? I help anytime.
So you have the young white branch. As you can see, he could see all the way down here. But what the hell is that down there? Guys, we're actually going to fight this thing. I'm in the mood for some fighting. We can't see with the binoculars very well. Very well. Hope you guys are excited. That's the first mini-boss we're going to try and fight today. The first. It won't be the last. I tell you that much. I want to thank everyone in this intermission of this thing coming up for actually sticking with the Let's Play so far. I know it's been kind of long and... Well, it's been not been long, it's been longer episodes, but it's the only way I can really get this done in the way I want it to be. I want this to be a really, really cool walkthrough style playthrough. And the only way I can really do that is by playing the game at my own pace. It's a little bit different than what I would usually do, like Resident Evil and stuff. So he made his way up. This dig made his way up. But what I'm going to do is be smart. And I'm gonna get a bonfire down here. Which means we're gonna have to do a bit of running, guys. One of the biggest mistakes I always like see people play whenever people come to my house and I'm like, hey, you wanna play some Dark Souls in there? Yeah, that sounds awesome. And usually it turns out that they constantly, like, attempt... They constantly attempt to like run, to not run past some enemies, and there's a bonfire right out here, guys. It's like the Holy Grail. Just open the doors. Just swallow your pride and open the goddamn door. And he can't attack you because of iframes. And just hit the bonfire. Don't worry, we're not going to the Road of Sacrifices yet. There's still a lot to do here. A lot to do here. We have to pick up those items we missed back there. We have to pick up a lot of items. Okay. This guy's tough. He can frostbite you like he just did there. But again, as you see there, he can kill you as well. Oh no. He's a fun little enemy. I remember fighting him in the network stress test for the first time, and ultimately being really impressed by the character design. And wait for the popping textures. Are you gonna? Oh god, there you go. I was ultimately impressed, I guess, by the overall character design and the actual boss mechanics, because I thought it deserved to be a boss here. Oh, look at that. Do you see that damage? This is why this weapon should be banned from everything. Look at that. Freaking hell, guys. Oh god. Don't die. Again. Oh, the weapon does such good damage though, guys. Don't worry about it. It happens. That's what we gotta realize. It happens. Death happens. It's not supposed to happen in your life, but like in Dark Souls, it happens. Okay. Same method. Do we have any pine resin? Because that would... I want to see what damage it does with just some pine resin. Doesn't seem... We have a pine bundle, which is good. It's actually exactly what we need. And I don't think pine bundles actually make any noise. So it looks like we're going to be saying hi to our good friend here. Oh shit, he caught on. He caught on fast. I don't want to die 3 times to this guy. If you remember, we actually got frostbitten as well by the first boss. The first boss that's not the tutorial boss. No shame in healing, this isn't a PvP fight. Look at the reach on this weapon is insane as well. Like, it's absolutely insane, guys. So we got the Ithril Straight Sword, and we got an Ember. Let's heal up and we'll go up and talk to our friend Siegmeier. Again, there's just some methods that can get you through the game quite easier than actually just... Like, if you play Souls, like I've played Souls religiously for the past, 4 years. And after a while you just realize that if there's a big enemy and there's a door that you can open, always open the door, because you don't know what you're gonna miss, guys. Especially if like there's a bonfire right past there. Just go for the door. Go for the door. And yes, Road of Sacrifices will be the next area we go to after this. Okay, I did that completely wrong, but hey, it's fine. Road of Sacrifices is way cooler. It's actually one of the cooler areas in the entire game. I quite like it. I think it's a really interesting area because it's, again, one of a kind. Like, the one of a kind areas in Souls games are the ones that really, really interest me. The ones that, like, there's just a small area in between places. Kind of reminds me of Harvest Valley, in Dark Souls 2. Maybe a bad example, but I think Harvest Valley was so unique because there was no other area like it, and it was very short. It was a very short area. Let's do this right.
Don't disappear like that. You had me downright worried. But thanks to you, an epiphany has struck me square in the head. I've unraveled the riddle of this inscrutable lift.
What you got for us?
On some days, I begin to doubt myself. I went up the tower, so I thought, then somehow ended up here. I'm not exactly sure what happened. Anyhow, do you see that? That humongous beast. I'm no coward and I have a steady hand, but that thing...
Hey, big boy.
No! You should have waited.
I love the Katarinas more than any of the creatures in all of Souls.
Fight by your side.
Oh. That's actually a first. And that's why we hit the bonfire. Fucking hell, guys. We can do this. We can do this. That's, it's not a hard fight anyway. Morn's armor. Black armor bestowed upon the Knights of Kareem. Modeled on Morn, the Archbishop's Apostle. Okay. See, this is why we got the bonfire. This is why we got the bonfire, guys. Again, this is why I didn't put walkthrough in the title of this video. Because I don't want people to get the wrong idea that I am just this all-knowing, never-dying god. Let's keep it going. This is my second playthrough. Let us go up. Let us go up. I love that, man. That the way they kind of took it out of Dark Souls 2 kind of upset me, kind of. Not entirely, but upset me slightly. We are now in the Undead Settlement. So basically, the trigger for that fight is Sigurd sees you're in trouble and basically tries to help you. He thinks you're an honorable man because you helped him surpass this cruel, cruel puzzle. It's okay, dude. You okay?
On some day.
Yep. And now we go back down again. This time, I'm gonna use an ember. Just to make sure I don't die. Let's do it. This is the last mini-boss we're gonna face in this episode, by the way. After that, it's, Do you remember me, bitch? I should actually take more caution when I do this. It's the reason why I die is because I'm just like so overconfident when I go into this.
I seek word of the Knights of Katarina, right by your side.
Gotta watch it out. You gotta watch out, guys. Oh, you leave him alone. You leave him alone. He's on fire. He's on fire. I'm on fire now. I'm on fire. No, leave me alone. Go after him. Go after him, Balrog. Oh, good man. Good man. Good man. Being the patsy. Whew. He's not easy, guys. He's not easy. Okay, you okay? Oh shit, 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 watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out. You okay, Sigurd, I should say? We did it! We got a fire gem for our trouble.
That was quite a performance. But you mustn't get in over your head.
You're right. I died because it got him over my head.
We must put our duties first. But, for the moment, we've a toast to make. To your valor, my sword, and our victory together. Long may the sun shine.
So we now get toast as an emote. Let's check, let's do this now. Just to be nice. Just be nice, let's toast. Let's toast our good friend Sigmund. Okay, so... not too bad, guys, not too bad. Okay, do we have a bow on ourselves? We do. We have a longbow. Not that bad, guys. Not that bad. Let's knock this down. We're about to get actually not a crucial item, but a pretty fun item, I guess. You could say. I don't know if we're gonna use it in this playthrough, but the thing is, we're probably gonna have low equipment loads through this entire playthrough, so it might make sense to actually use it. I don't know. Let's go see if we're gonna use it. Vote now. This is an alluring skull, I think. No, it's a red bug pellet. Is the one upstairs in the ring skull? Please don't make me feel stupid. Okay, this guy's gonna drop down, then it's an alluring skull. Yes. I love the great sight so much. Things will keep getting complicated, a little bit more complicated as we go up this area. It's kind of just a cool side area just to get a few items. Not entirely important to the story at all. Well, I guess to get Flynn's ring, which was introduced in the Dark Souls 2 DLC, I believe? The Crown of the Sunken Kin. King, not kin. Okay, so this chest here is not worth it, but we're gonna go for it anyway. Human pine resin. We have no Estus flask, so we have to be incredibly careful here. Look at this. Look at the humanity. Oh, I don't like it, guys. What is my special? Oh, let's try that. That didn't do much. Okay, so this attempt right here to get up here will probably kill us. So just know that now. Know that I tried. Oh shit, shit, shit! 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 Yeah, we did it. Don't worry. Don't worry! There was never any doubt. Let's get this item here. Flynn's ring. Awesome. And we can actually drop back down here. And we're gonna actually get us some more items. I don't think we're gonna be able to last these drops, lads, I'm sorry. I thought it was gonna be we were gonna be able to, but do I have a divine blessing on me or something? Something to heal me up. Nothing. Nothing at all. Wait. Oh, fuck yeah. Shit, dead. Fuck, that was just such a mishap. Fucking hell. Dying to fall damage is the worst thing in this game. We're probably not going to go back and get those items, but if you want those items, just drop down there and you can actually easily get them. But we kind of want our souls back, don't we? Don't we just? It's just 8,000 souls. It's actually not that useful. We're probably going to leave them. I might get them in, like, on the way back if I don't die. Okay, what's next? To finish us up this area, really, you have to go down into the pitted area, and then we're pretty much done. It's kind of a cool area. We're kind of done with the Undead Settlement then. Let's head down there. Four deaths. One to fall damage, guys. This is not going good in a 30-minute span. Not going good at all. Not going good. Let's try this. Just barely, guys. Let's put back on our armor. I take off the armor because it's easier to... Oh, we got northern gloves. Let's wear those instead. Actually, let's wear the normal gloves and then put Flynn's ring on just to test it out. We have a few rings, actually. We're not going to wear them all. We're going to wear the bleed resistance ring. And then we can just go through here. Do we have any firebombs? That's the question. We have 6. Why do we need firebombs, though? For this guy over here. He's a cunt. And then we're just left with mano a mano with this guy, the final boss. Soul of a deserted corpse, soul of a deserted corpse. So wait, Saint's Talisman, why would a Saint's Talisman be here? That doesn't make any sense. I mean, why? Why would a Saint's Talisman be here? It's like a saint who could teach miracles would be here.
Yoo-hoo-hoo.
Hello.
Who is there? Someone there? Anyone? Oh, please. Whoever you are, touch me. The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh. Little creatures, they never stop biting. So please, hold out your hand and touch me.
Why not, guys?
Ah, yes, there you are. So close, indeed. Then I am not entirely alone, just yet. Praise the merciful gods above. Oh, forgive me. I am Irina of Karim. I came to this land so that I might be a firekeeper. Your touch has freed me from the darkness. You are a champion, then. I am weak and unfit to tend the flames. But if it would not trouble you, might I enter into your service instead? Oh, thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Karim, solemnly swear to serve you.
All right, I think she's the one that sells miracles. If not, hey, whatever.
Let's keep it going.
And then we're back out here. But we're not finished down here. This is the last area we have to go to. We're not finished down here at all. There's still some items we have to get. Oh my god. I press descend and it touches the bloodstain. It's okay, guys. It's okay, for fuck's sake, guys. Oh my god, how many times have we ended up back here? Holy crap. We should have cleared this area by now. We're almost done. We're almost done. We're almost done. Yeah, we're almost done. Just a little bit left. At least now we can try and descend the stairs. It's because... I don't know, man. Man, that was just funny. That was just a funny death. That was just a funny... Oh, this guy, I think he said it comes into our service as well.
You've gone and rescued her, have you? How very quaint. Pitying creatures that are beyond help. Very well. I'm sick of looking after her at any rate. I am Egon, a knight of Karim. I am allied to you for as long as you assure the girl's safety. And only for that long.
That kind of has me thinking, is she gonna die to some death after a while? Maybe? Maybe, guys? Okay, let's see. Descend the ladder. Oh shit, there's a rat here. We gotta escape. We gotta fucking escape. Forgot about the rats. Oh, it's okay, they can't get up ladders. They can't get up ladders. One of the fatal flaws of the noble rat. Do you remember that locked door I showed you guys earlier, actually? We're actually gonna get to go to behind that right now. Oh, the doggy! Frame rate doggy! I love frame rate doggy, he's the best. Hello? Hello, sir. Excuse me. Excuse me. What are you leading me to? I love that it's totally leading you into a trap. A heavy gem. I should remember that, actually. Remember, these guys cause bleed damage. That weapon is so cool, though. I wish that was the version we actually got. In Dark Souls 2, the scythe was not nearly as good, but you had to hit a sweet spot. You had to be a little bit further away. Okay, that's another Titanite shard, and I think we're getting another one now as well. Yes, yet another Titanite shard. Okay, this episode's gonna run long a bit, but that's just because we died four times. It's cool though. Wait, what? Here we are. Wondering when you guys are gonna show up. I was worried. This is like the catacombs. It's not the catacombs. But is there a catacombs? I don't know. If you're in the catacombs right now, actually, just don't worry. It gets a lot easier once you get to the second bonfire. Oh, I like your hat! Oh, you can backstab with a scythe, apparently. Pillage remains. Okay. Red-hilted halberd. Right down here is a covenant, which we're not going to join. And then here, right here, is where the dock door was from earlier, where the big giant rat was. Okay. A loincloth. A loincloth, my good patrons. Okay, so what are we going to do now? Since we've looted every single part of this area, there is still some items that we have to collect. So I say we go and collect those items right now. That's right. If you guys want to, like, slip out right now, there's nothing going to happen for the rest of the episode. I've done all I need to do really here. I'm just going to collect the items that I missed along the way. So if you guys want to slip out right now, that's completely fine. And I'll see you in the next one tomorrow. But for the people that are staying, let's go collect some of the... Oh, shit, I forgot I have to go through here again. It's okay. Okay, let's see if I can do it. Let's see if we can do it. Oh. Okay, apparently it was pretty easy to do it. So, that's fine. Usually I wouldn't have died trying to descend down a freaking ladder. I love that aspect though. Love the aspect of the game. Okay, let's go and collect some items that we missed over here. Let's try and run for it, guys. Oh, that's not a stairs. Ah! Fuck! That hurt! Excuse me. Okay, this is gonna take a shit ton of running, guys. Just to collect these. Alluring skull. That's right, I did all that for alluring skull. I didn't even do it for fun. I did it for an alluring skull. Oh, that's where the guy drops down on you. Oh, we did it. We got the item we need to get, and now we're gonna get the last item we need to get. The items we missed. If there's any items we missed, just let me know, and then at the end of the next episode, I'll go back and get them. Leave me alone. Thank you. Thank you very much. Just go up or down? Down, of course! Of course! We gotta go up to get the last of the items. Let's just go up. Oh, it was six deaths in this episode. Because there was the two fall damage ones. Two deaths from the frost guy. A death from the fire guy and a death from the butcher. Yep. It's okay though. We will redeem ourselves one day. You guys know the items I'm going to get, right? You know that's just petty. It's me being petty. I just need those items. There's a few items down here that I missed. It's good to have all the items because you never know when you get something pretty useful, like a Homer bone. Just good collecting all the items. Just good to collect all the items, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'm trying to remember if there's any items over here. There probably is. But the items that I'm really worried about not collecting, we're gonna have to do at the start. Large club, pretty good. We're gonna have to do the start of the next episode. Because I'm almost out of time. I try to keep the, like, if an episode goes longer than 50 minutes, then I'm kinda like, maybe this episode's gone a little bit too long. But I kinda like it to be that long because it's... I don't know. It's a Dark Souls game, guys. It's gonna be long. And arduous.
Look at that.
Wait, was that the damage of Flynn's ring? Don't die. Do not die. Do not die. Don't leave me alone. Leave me alone. No, we're not dying again. Okay, good. Ooh. Now he can drop down there. He'll make his way back up. But by the time that he comes back up, we'll be already gone. Excuse me. You laughing at me? Again, guys, this ain't a walkthrough. If you guys are literally watching this to be like, okay, what do I do next? I'm just playing a casual playthrough. Okay, let's do this properly this time. That was not properly! Fuck! Oh my luck. My luck. Okay guys, look. I don't know what to tell you guys. That one went way smoother. We're getting these items. I said I would clear every single area, and we're gonna do that. To the best of my knowledge, I guess we're gonna clear every area. Oh god, I thought I was gonna die there again. Oh god. Okay, we have to do this properly this time, guys. Roll. Oh, for fuck's sake, God. Thank the Lord. Got a Claranthi ring, so freaking worth it. Mirror vest, so worth it. Like, oh god, that was so worth it, guys. So freaking worth it. Fucking fall damage. Well, there you go, guys. That is the Undead Settlement. Finished. Finito. Done.